There are people who disappear off the face of the earth, or even entire towns that suddenly vanish, like for instance the Roanoke colony. But when entire civilizations suddenly go missing without a trace, that's when things really get interesting. I'm your host Raphael, and thanks for watching. This is the series where I tell you a story, its subsequent theories and explanations, and then I let you make up your mind. If you like the weird, the wonderful, the creepy and the mysterious, you might want to subscribe to my channel and click the little bell to receive notifications. Also, if you enjoy this vid, you can like and share, and let's find out about this obscure Chinese culture that mysteriously vanished. Sangxingdu, literally translated as Three Stars Mount, is an archaeological site and a major Bronze Age culture in what is now modern Guangdong, Sichuan, China. Archaeologists excavated remarkable artifacts that radiocarbon dating placed in the 12th or 11th centuries BC. They have identified the locale with the ancient kingdom of Shu, and the discovery at Sangxingdu challenges the traditional narrative of Chinese civilization spreading from the central plain of the Yellow River. Another one that will rewrite the history. In the spring of 1929, a farmer was digging a well when he discovered a large stash of jade relics. Chinese archaeologists searched the area without success until 1986, when workers accidentally found the pits containing thousands of artifacts that had been broken, burned, and then carefully buried. The objects found in the sacrificial pits included animal-faced sculptures and masks with dragon ears, open mouths and grinning teeth, human-like heads with gold foil masks, decorative animals including dragons, snakes, and birds, a giant wand, a sacrificial altar, a 4-meter or 13 feet tall bronze tree, axes, tablets, rings, knives, and hundreds of other unique items. Among the collection was also the world's largest and best preserved bronze upright human figure, measuring 2.62 meters or 8 feet. Great, a lot to work with then. The culture of the Sangxingdu site is thought to be divided into several phases. The first phase belongs to the Boadun, and the final phase, the culture merged with Ba and Chu cultures. It was a strong central theocracy with trade links to the bronze, yin and ivory from the Southeast Asia. Such evidence of independent cultures in different regions of China defies the traditional theory that the Yellow River was the sole cradle of Chinese civilization. Told you, history rewrite. This ancient culture had a well-developed bronze casting culture, which permitted the manufacture of many impressive articles. The proof is in the world's oldest life-size standing human statue and a bronze tree with birds, flowers and ornaments, which some have identified as the renderings of the Fusang tree of Chinese mythology. The most striking finds were dozens of large bronze masks and heads, represented with angular human features, exaggerated almond-shaped eyes, some with protruding pupils and large upper ears, many of who had traces of paint smears, black on the disproportionately large eyes and eyebrows, and vermilion on the lips, nostrils and ear holes. Based upon the design of these heads, archaeologists believe they were mounted on wooden supports or totems, perhaps even dressed in clothing. Very impressive indeed. Covering about 3 square kilometers or 2 square miles, Sangxingdu was the metropolis of its time and had highly developed agriculture, including winemaking ability, ceramic technology, and sacrificial tools. Also, mining was commonplace, According to archaeological findings, the settlement at Xiangzhou was abandoned suddenly around 1000 BC and came to an abrupt end. Beamed up by aliens, perhaps? So why did this civilization disappear? There are several theories about this. What else did you expect on this channel? A large devastating flood is one of the hypotheses set up to try to and explain the disappearance. Another is that they simply devoted too many resources to religious activities and they eventually ran out of them. This puts them on par with the culture of Easter Island, a society believed to have steered slowly towards annihilation in a fatal wish to please the gods. Similar self-defeating behavior may have spelled doom at Xiangzhou. They prayed themselves into oblivion? How long does that work? Did an earthquake cause landslides that dammed the river high up in the mountains, rerouting its flow? A catastrophe that may have reduced Xiangzhou's water supply, spurring its inhabitants to move. Some historical records support their hypothesis, as in 1099 BC, ancient writers recorded an earthquake in the capital of the Zhou dynasty, roughly 400 kilometers or 250 miles from the historic site of Xiangzhou. But the latter culture didn't have writing, so it is possible the earthquake epicenter was actually closer to Xiangzhou and just went unrecorded. Geological evidence also suggests that an earthquake occurred in the general region at that time. Death by natural causes. Oh. None of these, however, explain why these people destroyed their entire culture and buried it into two pits, or why the culture didn't emerge at the Jinsha. So, another explanation, more belligerent in nature, is put forward. Did they collapse under the weight of massive immigration from further east? The decline of the Xiangzhou culture coincides with the arrival of the Ba, a mysterious tiger-worshipping people. The Ba people were generally peaceful, but frictions must have been there. Could there maybe have been even a war? What? No aliens? Oh, come on, you know better than that. Around the time of the discovery of the artifacts, locals in the area alleged that they spotted UFOs in the area. This, combined with the sometimes odd or arguably alien-looking masks and heads, makes some believe extraterrestrials were involved both in the creation and destruction of this ancient Chinese civilization. Yeah, these masks and heads couldn't possibly represent a dead person or spirit of long-lost ancestors, now could they? Of the many mysteries surrounding the Xiangzhou civilization, the most intriguing is that of its sudden disappearance. Whatever happened to this advanced culture? You decide! There is a lot more to say about this topic than I did in this small vid, so if I forgot something or you have something to add, don't hesitate to do so. If you wish to do your own research, the links in the description below might be a good start. Your thoughts and opinions are much appreciated, so drop a line, also in the box below. Just be respectful in the comments, as there are real people with real feelings on the other side. And I hope to see you next time. Bye!